Recently, I've been reading through the book of 1 John, and in 1 John chapter 4 and verse 9, it says this: "By this the love of God was manifested in us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might live through him." So in other words, John is going back to this idea that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that we could have life because of Jesus coming. And then he goes on a couple of verses later in verse 11 to say this: "Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another." And I think that often when we think about loving other people, we look around the world around us and we say, I love other people because I don't do that, whatever that is in our mind that you would be something you would do if you don't love people. But we tend not to look at how God has loved us and apply that standard to how we love other people. God loved us in a way that was painful. God loved us in a way that was sacrificial. He loved us in a way that was costly. He loved us in a way that caused Jesus to have to move out of, if you would, his comfort zone. And so often those are things that we don't want to do. If that's what's required to love somebody, if it's costly, if it makes us uncomfortable, if it's a sacrifice, then we don't want to do it. So today I would encourage you, as you take a few minutes to look at your own life and to ask yourself, where am I showing the kind of love that God has shown to me? You know, Jesus talked about the fact that it's easy to love people who love us. It's expected that we would love our family and friends. There's really no credit in that. It's when we can step out of our comfortable circle, when we can step out of those people that on a human level, it's easy to love, and move into those places where it might be uncomfortable or costly, that we are truly demonstrating the type of love that God has shown to us.